Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And we just thought you might want to take a look at what our yard looks like at this time of year. So we're going to call this one July Garden Tour. Normally we don't see this part of the yard. This is the front of the house, the part that you view from the street. And it's our more wild, grow as you wish kind of area. Not quite so formal as our other areas, perhaps. I think this is Rick and Skye's favorite part because they like this tight, closely knit, different plants growing in abundance. And I'm the one that kind of likes the more formal area. But for those people who were afraid when we pulled out all those daisies and columbines that we were getting rid of too much, this is how it looks on the outside. Well, just so you know that there is never a time when we don't have to work on something, you can see that not only do we have grasses and black-eyed Susans growing, but we also have an abundance of nice tall thistles and weeds and trees that we've pulled them out once, and I guess we'll pull them out again.
Somehow I don't think we'll ever pull them out completely.
No,
I like how your honeysuckles are starting to follow the fence.
Yes, they are. They're going up the trellis like we had planned.
That's exactly what we were after.
Mm-hmm. And this is the other side then of the river birch. You see it from this side and a different clump of grasses. These are our big sedums, our autumn beauty, I don't know what they're called, autumn sedums.
They actually are red.
Yes,
red
and
flowers.
I was going to trim these back, and it's just once the rain started, they grew too big. They are already going to blossom, so I guess I'm not going to trim them back this year like I usually do. Then this is tickweed, sometimes known as tickweed. It's a kind of coreopsis. We had them at one point. I realized they were going to get carried away on themselves, so we moved them here. And now Rick just loved them, so he said, oh, just let them go. These are Stelladora lilies that we got from our neighbor. She was moving things around in her yard and said, if you want some, you can have some. This is one of our new peach trees, which has peaches on it.
In fact, it's our only fruit trees that, the new fruit trees that we got that actually have fruit on it.
Right, they're only the new ones have them. Then another kind of grass, a variegated grass. One of my favorite, liatris, that very tall one. This is the ash tree trying to regrow from when we chopped it down.
It's a pretty bush.
I'll be coming out here again to chop that back. These are rose mallow, these purple ones. Again, I planted them one time from seed way in the back. And then I sprinkle the seeds out here.
They sure are pretty. I really like how they work together
with the orange.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Very, very
yep.
pretty combination.
They're doing a nice
and
job.
This tall.
This I believe is a weed.
Really?
It will be chopped out of here before it goes to seed. Yes.
Well, it's almost to seed, and sure is attracting a lot of little flies.
Right. Yep. This is buttercups over here. You can see one of the little buttercups right there. This is, to me, this is taking over. I'm not pleased with it.
Yeah, but this was beautiful a couple of weeks ago where this was just filled with beautiful yellow little flowers. I liked it. Mm-hmm. Look at this peach tree.
Yes, that is lovely. And next to it, you'll see the tiger lilies.
Yep. And of course,
behind you see the fleece plant, the giant fleece plant.
Yeah, that's almost 6 foot tall already.
Yes.
And we don't know what kind of tree this is, do we?
No, but it does have spikes on it. If you're not careful, as it gets older, I don't know. But I want to say it's some kind of a quince because we have two other tree bushes that look like this.
So is it a bush or a tree?
Quince.
Because I know we staked it to that copper pole back there, remember?
Yes.
But now it's starting to branch out or root itself out.
It's doing really well.
But this is so nice and thick as a little carpet. I really like that. I mean, it's a change of pace from the other areas.
Well, that's for sure. Again, more rose mallow. That is a millet that's growing there.
That real tall one in
yes.
the center there?
We bought that once also, and it normally, it just kind of seeds itself wherever it wants, so all of a sudden there'll be one. This, I believe, is a
basswood?
Basswood that we got from the
Arbor Society.
Arbor Society. Yeah. Remember, you know, sometimes if you donate $10 to the Arbor Society, they'll send you 10 little trees, and you have your choice of which variety of trees you want. I believe the basswood tree is one of the trees we got. Again, more tickweed. More daisy, more tiger lilies, more Stelladora lilies.
And I see a lungwort in here.
Right. There is
more
sedum. my lilies of the valley that I'm trying to eradicate. This was also a tree. This was a maple tree, and sure enough, here it is, trying to regrow. I've already chopped this one down once. This is a peony, and these are
milkweed
pods.
Yeah.
This is a burning bush that was chewed down to almost nothing by the rabbits. You can see, and it is just flourishing. I wish it would stay that way, but
more milkweed.
This is milkweed, and the reason we allow this milkweed to grow, and I have been pulling it out and pulling it out, just trying to keep it under control, is this is the source of food for monarch butterflies. They come in the spring from Mexico, and way to the south of us, they fly up here. They eat these, and there's four generations that will be born during the summer, and that last generation will again fly down to Mexico for the winter. So they have never actually flown to Mexico. They were born here. They fly to Mexico. They will come back to the same yard come next spring. And this is the fun. And sometimes you're lucky enough if you can find a leaf that has eggs on it. Usually you'll see the leaves chewed off.
Yeah,
and you'll see it chewed off. We have some over there that have been chewed.
Well, at least their butterflies are smarter than I am. They fly south for the winter.
Now, this is some of the awful, horrible garlic mustard that I will have to dig out of here. That just tries to take over. And in the back here, we have a little Japanese maple that is trying its darndest to grow.
And another dogwood?
Yep, that's a burning bush.
Burning bush, rather.
Again, that was chewed off by the rabbits.
Now, our hedge took a real beating this year. I mean, most of it's coming back, but you can see how this winter just destroyed so many arborvitaes. And
this is a boxwood, and this was really burned by the sun of the winter and the wind and the freezing and thawing and freezing and thawing. This is our mystery tree that we have kept shaped as a lollipop, and we've decided now that it's time for us to let it go. So
the birds love it. I see birds disappear in here all the time.
And again, those are daisies in there. In case anybody was worried about the daisies, there they still are.
More milkweed.
Milkweed.
Look at these, they're taller than you are.
Yes, they are. And they have a very, very pleasant fragrance to them. I can see why they would be attractive to nectar-loving butterflies and perhaps hummingbirds even, because they are very fragrant. And this is another of the giant fleece. They too have a smell to them. Like I said, it reminds me of leather for whatever reason. More burning bush down there. Now, we were afraid those wouldn't even come back because they were so badly chewed. And I see that your tickweed has made it around the corner here. There's another one of our new peach trees with little peaches on it.
Yep, doing well.
Here is a black walnut that has been planted by the squirrels that will be leaving us. More grass. On the trellis, you'll see the
honeysuckle.
The honeysuckle, and behind that is our lilac bush. And someone asked, well, why don't you ever let it have flowers? The problem is we don't want it to get any bigger than that, and so every year we keep cutting it down, and as a result it just doesn't form flowers anymore.
It's kind of like giving it a haircut.
We do. Now look at this. In the spring there was nothing here. You couldn't see anything. There were no shoots showing, no nothing. And this is how much it has grown just this summer.
Well, the one in the back is at least 2 feet taller than you. So that one back there is probably close to 7 foot tall.
And this is probably our biggest one because this is in full sun. They will grow in a shaded, you know, partly shaded area, but they will get huge if you leave them in. And once this is done, I will go back and I will probably take a third of this or maybe a half of it away. This is our trumpet vine. This one was not chewed off during the winter. I guess rabbits and deer don't care for this. This definitely needs to be trained here because it's just going everywhere.
Well, again, the purpose when we eliminated our wood fence, our wood berm, we put in this metal fencing, what we call the dog fence, to keep the dogs in. And the reason we planted so many,
honeysuckle. The vines.
We wanted the vines to really take over the entire fence area and be full of beautiful flowers, all different colors.
Like a living fence.
Now, does this have a flower?
Yes, these have bright yellow, I believe, trumpet flowers. So that will have to be directed. These are phlox, not flax, but phlox, true phlox. This again is a river birch. Our grandson was helping defoliate it the other day. So looks like it's been pulled apart in some places and not others. That's because it has. That little bush right there is a holly. This is a phlox that moved itself. I do have some slug problems going on with these particular hostas, but oh well. They're not bothering those hostas over there.
Ooh, look at the pretty roses. Are those roses back
yes,
there?
Yes, those are roses.
Oh, wow.
In the shade.
I didn't even see them.
Mm-hmm. We planted those shortly after the fence.
Huh. Let me go back and get a closer look. Oh, those sure are pretty. And again, the honeysuckle going up the vine. I do love the bark on these river birch, the exfoliating kind. And you like the smoke
This is a purple leaf smoke tree. And I think we've spoken about it before. It was supposed to be a tree. It started out as a tree. The first winter, it almost died because it was a harsh winter, I guess. So we decided we would let it grow into a bush because it started coming up from the bottom. And it is just a lovely, that purple is so intense.
It's actually kind of luminescent,
yes.
Or chatoyant, I guess would be a word.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It and glistens.
In the spring, whoever might have seen the spring video, there were these beautiful plants in here that were about this tall. And they had blue and pink flowers on them. And I said, once these are done, they will totally disintegrate and be gone. And you'll forget they were even there unless you take pictures of where they are. And now you can see. You can't even see where the leaves were. They're gone. But they're in there. They'll come up next year. There's also a bunch of maple trees we need to be taking out again. This is our Austrian pine, is it? Or... Romanian pine?
No, I think it's, I think Austrian was occurred.
Possibly.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't sound right, though.
No, somebody may remember what we said it was. And this again is a mock orange. We put another honeysuckle there, which is not doing well at all. I don't know why. This is a tiny baby. What are those? Not a hibiscus. I'll think of it. Anyway, There's another honeysuckle, another one, and another one everywhere you see a trellis. What is the name of that plant? This is the rose bush that we planted for Rick's mom, and it's prolific.
Hi, Mom.
And these were two little rose bushes that Rick bought in little pots on Mother's Day. And we planted both of them there. They have probably tripled their size because they were just in little 3-inch pots when we got them. Again, we have the fleece plant. I'm not sure what that is, but it's lovely. And now you're seeing it from the opposite view. We were looking in, now we're looking out. These were a Siberian
Irises.
This is Russian sage right here. That behind there is Ligularia. It's a very exotic looking plant. Oftentimes during the day it'll kind of collapse, as you see, and then as it gets cooler in the evening the leaves will spread out again.
I like how this little maple has survived. I mean, it's one of the few that have really taken off.
Yes, it has.
Size-wise.
Very fern leaf. And behind them are allium that I'm letting go to seed this year. And we can't remember quite what that tree was.
Another mystery tree.
Mm-hmm. And then this is a flowering cherry. Well, now that we're over here to this other plant, which is the same as the one that I couldn't remember the name, Rick thought of it, it's hydrangea. This one obviously has flowers. Last year, I think we had one flower. The year before that, we had no flower. So it is wonderful this year. It's just gorgeous.
Well, think of all the rain we've had.
True.
I mean,
this is true. Once that rain started, everything blossomed. And then our hostas, which are in bloom and obviously very happy, even though they are in sun a lot of the time, as are these ferns. That is a witch hazel bush. Behind that is our original honeysuckle vine that's wrapped around that trellis. This is the tamarack bush,
which probably right now is going, I'd say, close to 20 feet.
Getting there.
It's at least, I'll take that back. It's a good maybe 11, 12 feet. It's almost twice as tall as I am, so I'd say it's about 12 feet, maybe more.
And then this is a stibble.
Stilby?
A stilby, thank you. And these are all balloon flowers that are growing in here.
Oh, look at your roses.
And the original roses that came with the house.
That we transplanted, maybe 3 years ago?
Mm-hmm.
We didn't think it would come back. Plus, then, maybe a couple weeks ago, this little sprout came up and actually had some flowers on it, remember?
Yes.
Had two blossoms?
That's right.
But it looks like, I don't know, has it been eaten?
Somebody's been chewing on it, perhaps.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And look at all the new little...
Right, those are liatris in there.
Yeah.
This is foxglove. And this is another one of those bushes, like the other one
on
the outside.
Don't we have a name on down there? I see it way down at the bottom.
Yes, it's a quince.
A quint.
Quince.
How do you spell that?
Q-U-I-N-C-E, quince.
Okay, quince.
And it did have red flowers on it this spring. It was very pretty.
And here's another one of our Japanese maples that didn't make it.
Right.
But look what's happening at the bottom.
Yep. And this is our new
Daphne. Yep.
And for those of you that remember the bulb kits that blossomed so beautifully in the spring, that's what's left of them. They're about ready to be snipped off. And this is our weeping flowering cherry.
Look what's in the tree.
Oh my gosh, it's a monkey up there. Look at that.
How did that monkey get up there?
Every now and again you find something in your trees that you weren't expecting, and look at what we found.
Do we get to keep them?
I think we should.
He doesn't speak.
Want to say anything, monkey? Nope. Nope, he's a non-speaking monkey.
Hmm.
This is the very front of the house, which gets shade probably half of the day. The hanging baskets are geranium, ivy geraniums, which are prolific in their blooms. They're a little at their like rejuvenating stage right now, so we have given them some nourishment, so they should be become fuller over the next week or so. And then these are all of the giant bleeding hearts, that some of them are sending out their seeds, obviously. When we started, we had two giant bleeding hearts here. They have seeded themselves all over the place. In the middle is a dwarf lilac, right, which did bloom this year. It was very lovely. Yeah. Rain barrels have been working excellently. We've used them for watering.
Can you even move that one?
No, we have had so much rain we can't even empty them, which is lovely, because as you can see over here, we still have three buckets of water that are in addition to what's in the rain barrel.
Well, every time it rains, I'll let one fill up, and then I'll run out here and fill up another one, and then run out again and fill up more.
Some of you may have seen the video where we were planting seeds. We first planted a bunch of them. There were cosmos and nasturtiums and bachelor buttons, and they didn't seem to be coming up, so we reseeded with the giant zinnias that I usually put in here, and we put some straw down. Then it rained again, and now we have all of them coming up in profusion, so it ought to be just beautiful.
Well, at least you found your favorite zinnias, and because you always like the giant zinnias.
Yes.
And it is absolutely beautiful when you come out here, especially when all the butterflies are flying around.
Oh, yes.
And hopping from one flower to another.
Yep, and they make great cutting flowers. So our daughter will come for lunch, and she'll take a bouquet back to keep on her desk at work.
You know, one thing I think I'd like to add to this video are your containers, because several people have asked how the containers are doing in the back.
Yep.
Let's go back and check those out.
Okay. This is our pond that used to be a three-level waterfall, but when that little monkey right there was a baby, we filled in the bottom so that he wouldn't have an accident, perhaps falling in. But it's beautiful to come out here in the morning and find which of the water lilies have decided to blossom that day. There's a couple of different varieties, so you'll never know for sure which one's going to come next.
They're beautiful. I do a lot of photography out here.
And then our neighbor gave us a duck decoy, and there he is, keeping his space.
Consider that this was a sycamore tree back here, about a 5.5-6 foot diameter grove that somebody had originally put together. We had to take it down because it was rotten inside.
Right, so that was a nice change, a good replacement for a tree.
Well, let's go look at those containers.
Come on, follow me. These are the hyacinth beans, and they are definitely getting ready to climb. They're going to need a structure soon. I'm anxious to see them when they have their purple pods. This is a golden squash, also from, I believe, Kathy. Then we have daylilies, yellow daylilies, and then there's the stargazer lily over there, some more
allium.
Hostas and allium bulbs. This is my second redoing in this bucket. Originally we had little pumpkins in here. They didn't come, so now they're cucumbers. And here are the container gardens that we did. early in the spring when it was, we were questioning whether it was too early to put them. These are the gladiolas, the dahlias, more gladiolas over there, and it's shady now, but it wasn't shady all during the day. And our elephant ears are finally coming out. They really like the soil to be warm, so if you plant elephant ears, don't try to get them in the ground too soon. They like to be warm before they will even show you that they're alive. This was our Cuban peppers, and we're still waiting for them. I don't know if that's them coming up or if that's weeds, but you know, sometimes things work and sometimes things don't. So,
well, I like how your rhododendron is finally doing something. We were really concerned because the other one looks horrible. I mean, it's,
well, the other one is more scraggly. This one is more rounded. And then you see, this is the hosta. This is a giant hosta that we've had for years. This one is in shade most of the day because of this pear tree. But then there's different varieties of them scattered around, as well as our wild geraniums, our oregano, and then these are our herbs that are growing and doing very well. You pretty much kind of ignore herbs. They like to do their own thing. So, looking in the garden, we've got our cherry tomatoes, our tomato berry tomatoes, our kale is doing well, onions doing well, peas,
strawberries.
Climbing up the trellis that we made out of string, behind them are the beans. It's regular bush beans, and then these are the fava beans that are doing very well also. And they're there, they're blossoming. So we've been told by our friends and viewer in Germany that you need to pick them when they're young, when they're tender and sweet and young. So we're keeping our eye on those.
And you got your strawberries covered?
We got our monkey that's eating the strawberries, and that's good. We put our straw down over it the other day. There's, you can see some nice big ones in there.
Tina?
Yes?
There's lots of bugs eating them.
Those little red bugs? Mm-hmm. Yes, those are the box elder bugs. I don't think that they are, but they're nasty.
They mostly eat all your strawberries.
These are our original peach trees. Again, we had no blossoms on them this year. I'm guessing this is a resting year. We're hoping that's what it is.
I'm amazed that those little bugs are actually starting to come out.
Yes, these right here. Oh, and then these were gladiolas. These were the ones that were left over. They were tiny. Some of them were just no bigger than a pea. And we didn't even know, you know, we figured those were baby bulbs, but we weren't sure. But look at, they are coming out. Each one is developing its own little leaf, including over here. You can see them better over here. So these tiny little bulbs that you sometimes see on the bottom of gladiola when you pick them in the fall, those are babies, and they will come up.
Yeah, look at that honeysuckle growing over the trellis, mm-hmm. over the arbor.
Yep.
That's pretty amazing.
So that's what our yard is looking like now at this time of the year. It's full and lush. And I remember one time Rick's mom, who lived in Las Vegas, came to visit about this time of year, and she was almost claustrophobic because it was just so dense and so close. Where we thought it was just fantastic and we loved the green and the denseness of it. To her, being used to the minimal desert plants and flowers, it was almost too much for her, but we like it. We hope you enjoyed our garden tour for what our yard is doing for right now. If you enjoyed it, please give us a thumbs up and send your questions and your comments. We'd love to hear from you. And as always, we'd love for you to join our garden family and subscribe to us.
And keep a lookout for our garden shout out, which is going to be coming soon. Again, we're asking our viewers, our subscribers and viewers, to send us a little 5 to 10 second video clip just saying hi, what part of the country or world you're from. Maybe if you have a website, you have a little sign, yeah. Or you know, have a shirt that represents your idea, your company.
Or what's growing in your yard right now, a flower, or a vegetable, or a fruit that you'd like to show off.
But we're going to call it a global garden shout out. So stay tuned. We'll do a video with the details on it. So yeah, hopefully if we get enough responses, we'll put a video together and post it so people can say hi from all around the world.
That would be great. Bye for now.